Hello and welcome to News Review once again from our lockdown home temporary studios. I'm in one part of London and Catherine is on the other side. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Neil. Hello, everybody. And today's story is about a music festival that will go ahead despite coronavirus.
Okay, well, that sounds like good news to me. Let's find out some more from this BBC News report.
The BBC Proms has unveiled a new programme to replace the original schedule, which was scrapped because of the pandemic. The event will open in July with a virtual concert inspired by Beethoven, recorded by 350 musicians in their own homes. There will be live performances at the Royal Albert Hall in the final fortnight of the season, culminating in the traditional last night in September.
Yes, so whilst most music festivals around the world have been cancelled due to coronavirus, the largest classical music festival in the world, known as the BBC Proms, will go ahead not quite as planned because they're going to start with online concerts and they will finish the season, which lasts about 2 months, with a real concert in a real concert hall.
Okay, well, you have been looking around at the world's media at how this story is being reported. You've picked out three useful words and expressions. What have you got?
Yes, we have virtual, mashup, and unthinkable.
Virtual, mashup, and unthinkable. So let's hear your first headline, please, with that word virtual.
Most certainly. We're starting right here in London with the Evening Standard. The headline, BBC Proms 2020 to hold virtual first night Beethoven tribute and live last night celebrations.
Virtual, appearing via the internet.
Yes, so virtual, spelt V-I-R-T-U-A-L. Now, the pronunciation of this word is really interesting. There is almost no resemblance to the way it appears in spelling. So the first thing is the I is pronounced in virtual. Then you've got the R-T, which is pronounced ch. Then the U is pronounced U, but the A is pronounced U. So you have virtual, virtual. How about that, Neil?
Yes, an interesting word because there is virtually no similarity between the spelling and the pronunciation.
I know. There is interesting you said there is virtually no similarity. What did you mean by that, Neil?
Almost no.
There is almost no similarity between the pronunciation and the spelling of the word virtually. Now, almost is a really good clue to the way that we're using virtually or virtual in this headline. Virtual means almost, but in terms of this kind of technology sense, when we talk about virtual reality, we're saying that something is almost real. So if you think about things like computer games, where you have a character, you go into a world, there are, you can move around it, meet other characters, it's not real, but it's almost real, or at least that's what the developers tell you, it's almost real. So if something's virtual online, it's almost real. And at the moment, we're doing lots of things, lots of virtual things online, aren't we, Neil?
We are. For example, last night I had some virtual drinks with some friends of mine. Virtual because obviously we are not able to be in the same place. We couldn't go to a real pub. So you hear people talking about virtual pub nights at the moment in the UK.
Yes, lots of things which aren't quite real, but you do them on the computer and they're almost real. And we do them using technology.
Okay, well, we're virtually done with this explanation, and let's have a summary. Okay, Catherine, time now for your second headline, please.
Okay, we're going to the Gazette, still in the UK here. The headline, BBC Proms reveals plans for mashup first night and live last night.
mashup media product which combines clips and music from a number of sources.
Yes, mashup. Two words here. First word, M-A-S-H. The second word, up, and they're joined together with a hyphen, that little line that joins words. Often you'll see it written just as all word without a hyphen, mashup.
Yeah, okay. Now I'm a little bit confused here, as I often am.
Are you thinking about potatoes right now?
I'm thinking about potatoes that you boil, and then you add butter and a drop of milk, and you mash them up to make mashed potatoes.
Lovely. I love mashed potatoes. And it's where you get five or six or plenty of potatoes, all single potatoes, but then when you boil them and you mix them together and you use a kind of metal tool called a masher to hit them with, and then they all become one. So you can't tell one from another. They're all mixed up together, Neil. And that's where... Can you see where I'm going with this?
I can see what you're doing here.
So if you get different pieces of media, you might get a bit of audio from one source and a bit of visual material from another source and maybe some video and some photographs and a bit of extra voice work, and you put them all together to make a new product. That's called a mashup, where you get different pieces of media, mix them together, make something else. There's lots of mashups you can see on the internet, aren't there, Neil? Any favourites?
Yeah, you can see something as simple as two famous people whose faces have been kind of merged together. That's a kind of very simple image mashup. But you also
get
videos and music from a variety of sources all put together.
Yes, I like the one where you've got Laurel and Hardy, the old black and white comedy characters, and they're dancing to modern music. I think those are really clever mashups. They're good fun.
Yeah, that's good.
What would you mash up if you could do a BBC Learning English mashup, Neil? What would your two products or more that you'd put together?
Oh, well, it would definitely have to be News Review and English for Cats.
Well, I think they'd make a better presenter than you. That's all I'm saying.
Don't you think that would be nice? This programme exactly, but a couple of kitty cats instead of us.
News, yeah, what could it be called? Cat reviews. News of the news.
News review.
News review. Let's move on.
Okay, let's have a summary of that, please. If you like stories about music and music festivals, we have another one for you, don't we, Catherine?
We do. Just a few weeks ago, we brought you a story about how most of the world's music festivals are being cancelled at the moment. So if you'd like to see that, just click the link in the description and you'll go straight to the programme.
OK, time now for our last headline, please.
Yes, now we are going to the Telegraph again here in the UK. The proms are part of our national psyche. A last night in isolation is unthinkable.
Unthinkable. Not possible to imagine.
Yes, so the spelling, unthinkable. Now, this is a kind of three-part word. The core of the word is the verb think. We have the suffix able, A-B-L-E, that makes an adjective. And then we've got the prefix un, which means not. So you get something that it's not possible to think about. If something's unthinkable, you can't imagine it.
It's not entirely true to say that you can't think about it. It's that you find the idea so awful that you really don't want to.
Exactly that. You can think about it, but you don't want to. And the idea of this thought becoming reality is a terrible one and something we must avoid at all costs. So just to explain a bit about the last night at the proms is a season of concerts. And at the very last night, there's a big celebration. Everybody gets dressed up. It's quite patriotic and British. People wave the flags around and things. And it's a real kind of national celebration. So this newspaper is saying that we can't allow this celebration not to happen. If something's unthinkable, we mustn't let whatever it is happen.
But as everybody knows, lots of unthinkable things have happened over the last few months. For example, you would have thought that the postponement or delay or even cancellation of the Olympics would be totally unthinkable.
Yes, another word for that is unimaginable. It was unimaginable that the Olympic Games could be cancelled, but they were.
Yeah. Rob, the other day,
he
said something to me very interesting. He said to me that he had given up biscuits completely.
I don't believe it.
It's absolutely unthinkable.
Unimaginable. It couldn't possibly happen. I can't even bear to think about it. It would never be, life would never be the same again.
It's simply wrong. Okay, let's have a summary of that word. Time now then just for a recap of our vocabulary, please.
Yes, we had virtual appearing via the internet, mashup, media product which combines clips and music from a number of sources, and unthinkable, not possible to imagine.
If you would like to test yourself on this vocabulary, there is a quiz on our website, bbclearningenglish.com. Stay safe, everybody. See you next time.
Bye.